So this is our last lecture on magnetic properties of materials, in which we'll be taking up ferromagnetic materials to understand some of its aspects. Now in ferromagnetic materials, chi is a function of H. Now this is unlike diamond paramagnetic materials, because if you can remember, in diamond paramagnetic materials chi was a constant, so that in the M versus H variation we get a straight line. But since here chi is a function of H, so variation of B versus H is not linear in ferromagnetic materials. Now if we analyze this BH curve step by step, in each step actually we will be getting some very important physical information regarding ferromagnetic sample. So next we are going to discuss and analyze these steps one by one. But before doing this, let's have a look of the BH curve for ferromagnetic samples. Now here you can see that there is a word hysteresis, so this particular word will be explained later. Now let's start our analyzing this particular curve step by step. First we'll be analyzing the part OC of the curve. Now in this part, what we're doing actually, here H is increased from 0, then we see that if we do so, if we increase H from 0 gradually, B increases along the curve OC. Now after C, if we further increase H, suppose up to C dashed, B does not increase anymore. Now what does it mean? This means the sample has become magnetically saturated with all its atomic dipole aligned in the field direction. And this particular phenomenon is called magnetic saturation. So the part OC of the curve has actually given us the information regarding magnetic saturation. Now let's go to the part CD of the curve. Now in this part, what we are doing actually, we are gradually decreasing H from this particular value C to 0. Now if we do so, you can see that though H is reduced to 0, B does not become 0. But if you can notice, when we started increasing H, B was 0 when H was 0. So this is actually because of the residual magnetization. So though H is equal to 0, some amount of magnetization, which is equal to OD, retains within the sample, and this is called retentivity or residual magnetization of the ferromagnetic sample. So this is our residual magnetization. Now next comes the part DE of the curve. Here what we are doing actually, now H is reversed. That means so far H was positive, now we are making H negative because this is the negative axis of H. So if H is now reversed, then you can see B also further decreases, and at E B becomes 0. Thus OE represents the reversed field which is necessary to destroy completely the residual magnetism, that means OD. And this OE is called coercivity or coercive force of the ferromagnetic material. Now if the field is reversed further, then what happens? Saturation occurs at F, and if H is now again reversed, that means if it is become if we are making it positive then and increased, then B follows the path FGK, becoming 0 at K and gets saturated again at C. So you can see that When the ferromagnetic sample is subjected to a cycle of magnetization, B follows a closed loop at each step of the loop, and at each step B lags behind the corresponding age. This phenomenon is actually called hysteresis. The word hysteresis means lagging behind, and this loop is called hysteresis loop. So with this we conclude our series of lecture on magnetic properties of material. Thank you.